In this video, I'm going to help you understand about the listener. So let me put it up on top. Then we're going to talk about the listener. You may be already aware of SQL. And whenever you want to connect from SQL Plus or SQL Developer, or if you're a developer who connects from an application, you would have to give three important attributes to connect to a database. Number one, the host, port, and then SID or the service name. So let's try to demystify what are these three. To begin with, let's say there is a database instance that is available, and let us assume this is running on a host. The database instance would typically have an SID which is equivalent to the DB name. I will talk about what is a service name later on. For now, let us say SID and service name are the same. SID would be the service identifier, or in other words, the instance name. Now, the database is running on a host, so the host piece is taken care of. The database has a name, so the SID is taken care of. So the question is, what is this port? Whenever we have a database instance running, we would have already installed the database software and then created a database. When we install the database software, typically you would have the network component called as a listener already configured. What is the purpose of a listener? As the name suggests, it is going to listen for something. That is why it is a listener. The listener's purpose is to listen for connection requests. So when you have an application running, and if you provide these three pieces of information and then provide a username and passcode to connect, the application basically reaches the listener, because the port that you have specified is the port on which the listener runs. The default port for the listener is 1521. You can configure the listener on any other port, but the listener that listens on 1521 is called as the default listener. What is special about the default listener? Any number of databases that you might create on this host will be listened by the default listener for connection requests. So, when you make a connection from your application to your database, the request first goes to the listener. The listener will then connect to the instance, and it creates a server process, which is going to be a server-side process on behalf of the application, which will work every SQL that you send from here on behalf of you. So this server process is spawned by the listener, and the server process will thereafter go and authenticate you, with which a session is established. So once this first connection request for a particular session comes here, thereafter the server process communicates with the application directly. The listener is out of the way. To help you understand this, if you had an office in which you are working, there is a receptionist or a board where an external person can try to reach you. So if I'm trying to reach you at your office, you might have shared to me your board number. I will first connect to the board and say, hey, please connect me to Mr. X. And then the board person transfers my call to you. Thereafter, the board or the receptionist is out of the call. Consider the listener to be something similar to that. It is only going to listen for connection requests, and once the connection is established, the listener is out of the way. The communication happens directly between the server process and the application or the client, and the queries are processed. The listener is configured using the file present at. I have written all in caps just for the purpose of legibility. You need to look at what is the directory structure that you have created when you installed. What is Oracle Home? The location where Oracle software has been installed. So it could be any path that you specified at the time of installation. Within the location where Oracle software has been installed, network admin folder, within which there is a file called listener.ora, which contains the specifications of the listener. The default listener is 1521, which will listen for all database instances. If you create a non-default listener, which is any port other than 1521, by default, no database is going to register for it. In order to make databases registered, there is a parameter called local listener, using which you point the instance to register with the listener. Who registers? We talked about a process called a PMON, process monitor, which is one of the background processes for a database instance. It is responsible for registering with the listener. When you specify local listener and you give a TNS alias pointing to a listener, the PMON will register with that. Additionally, listener.ara has a parameter called SID underscore list underscore listener name, which could also be used to make the listener to automatically listen for a list of instances if you are having a non-default port for the listener. So that's about the listener. Very simple. The purpose of listener is to listen for connection requests, and it is responsible for establishing a connection to the database. So you may have one or more listeners. The default listener is 1521. And this is a very, very critical process to establish connections to a database.